So in the exercise, we just created the element template and we modified the density attribute so that it's doing a table lookup that looks like that. Our next step is to go into the mass attribute and change its settings so that we define the formula. If you recall, we made the data reference in there a formula. So what I'll do is go back into my element template again. This is the template. I'll go into the mass attribute. As you can see, it's a formula. I'll choose the settings in order to set up this formula. So first I have to indicate the parameters or the inputs. The inputs will interrogate, well, when you click on this new input option here, or new parameters, it's going to interrogate the structure of the current element and find all those items that could be used in the calculation. So density, level, and volume, let me cancel out of that. Let me remind you, that's these three here, density, level, and volume. Those are the three that have a value type of double. The others are strings, and so it's not presented as a as an option to use in the formula. So if I go into mass and then settings, when I add parameters, as you can see, it will go out and find those parameters that might be appropriate. So in this case, I'm going to choose volume and density. So I think I'll choose a couple of variables that help me remember these two. I'm going to say V is equal to the volume, and that's going to pick up the unit of measure. Make sure you keep that unit of measure identified. That's going to help, you know, the come up with the right units for the answer. So I'll go ahead and add that. So you can see V equals volume, and it shows me the default. We're going to say volume times density is the mass, so we'll add density as a parameter. There it is. I'll choose D to represent that. We got the right unit of measure. So now that we've got these parameters intact, now we can build the equation. So over here on the equation side, this option here, add new formula row, it allows me to go out and to input an equation based on these parameters plus operators plus any constants that you may want to add. So for example, I just chose to add something here. I can choose to go out and find the variables myself. I can say, well, this is volume times density. That's the expression we're asking you to use. So I can just specify V for volume and then use for an operator times, and then specify this D for density. Now, I could have also just typed that in there. You're not required to use this. It's just something that we've included. So it's got easy access to certain functions. You can see the variables that you defined, etc. Now, one last thing is to make sure that you've got the right units of measure selected for your result. So as you can see over here in result, you've got a drop-down that allows you to choose what unit of measure you would like to show this in. We're going to show this in kilograms. You optionally have mins and maxes you can put in there. And now if I choose evaluate at this point, it should come up with it should come up with zero as a result, because my default values were all zero for that. So we're not really going to get any meaningful result here. And later on, when we actually associate elements with this element template, we'll be able to test using this evaluate. Okay, I'll go ahead and say OK. What we've got now is in the settings, we've defined how that calculation is done. And once I've checked this in, now I'm finished with my element template. We're ready to move on to the next step, which is to generate an element based on this particular template and then start making use of that element. So again, using our cookie cutter analogy, we've essentially come up with a cookie cutter in the shape of a butterfly, well, in the shape of a tank in this case. So here's the cookie cutter. We want to stamp some elements that are in the form of this tank template. So we do that not in the library, but we do that over here in the elements. So we'll go into elements. I'm going to create a brand new element. Again, you can do file, new element. You can do a right click here. Let's do a new element. And the first choice you get is what template, if any, you would like to base this element on. And I'm going to specify this tank template. Now, you also have the option to search for any category of template. I don't know if you remember, but when we were defining the template, we could have We could have additionally created categories of templates, you know, all your tanks, all your gauges, all your thermocouples, things like that could be different categories of template. I didn't choose any element template categories, and in any case I've got any selected there, so it should show me all those. The whole purpose of this is to restrict the list that is presented to you based on your choice of category. I'll go ahead and choose tank template. And what you should see here is an element that doesn't have any real values yet, but it has kind of the format that we require: the density, level, manufacturing, etc., photo, serial number. These are all the things we defined in the template. So here's our first element based on that template. I'm going to give this a name. I'm just going to call this Tank A. You can give it a description if you want. I'm going to swing over to the elements here, and I'll start modifying the elements. First, I'm going to choose level. Now, currently the data reference is set to none here. I'm going to make this a pointer to a pie tag. So I'm going to switch the data reference to a pie point. Once I've done that, then I can define which pie point we're actually going to be looking at. Yeah, there we go. As you can see, it recognizes there is no tag name specified, so I need to do that by going into Settings. And within Settings, I can do a search for any of the typical pie tags, so I can use the tag search option here to go out and find for specific, or look for specific tags. I'm going to look for all the tags that begin with the letters BA, so I'm looking for this one right here, BA:level.1. Now you could have also just typed that in there as well. In this example, I'm going to leave all these defaults just the way they are. Now, of course, if you're very interested in what options you have, you know, what do we mean by at or before? What are these different options for retrieving the data? The interested student could take a look in the, just go into the PyPC directory on your lab machine, and you'll find the help available for Py. Yeah, that's under Program Files, PyPC. And under Help, you'll see there's a number of AF help files. Go ahead and choose this AF.chm. And this is where you'll find a real good index of, or a good description of all the different things available within the within AF. So for example, under Data References, under Configuring the PyPoint Data Reference, this is where you'll find specifics on each of these different attributes, the ones that I'm just kind of leaving by default. So that's where you would find more information if you're interested. But as I said, in this example, I'm just going to leave the defaults. I'll go ahead and say OK. And I'll go ahead and acknowledge. Now what we should see when we look at this, if I go back out and take a look at the attributes, we should see that we're getting a value. I do see a value for level. The value is 0. If we actually take a look at this and hover, you can see there is a timestamp associated with that, so I'm pretty sure the value is 0. Let's move on to the next attribute we need to configure. This is going to be volume. For volume, we're going to change that also to a data reference of a pie point. So this is going to be a pie point data reference. And the tag we're going to associate this is going to be the tag called CDT158. So I'll go into Settings. Now this one I can just type in. I know this one off the top of my head. Again, I'll leave all these things the default. And as you can see, the configuration is now showing me that that does have a value, 118, and a timestamp. So this looks like good data is being associated with that particular attribute, good pie data. Now I'm just going to continue on and change the rest of the attributes the way it's described in the approach or in the step-by-step solution. So for product, for this particular tank, for product, the attribute or the value is going to be HC1500. Now you may remember that from our table that we created in back here in this library. That product HC1500, let's see if it's mapping to the table. Yeah, HC1500. Now, that's going to end up retrieving a density of 3422 when we do our calculation later on. Remember, that's the template, so let's go back to the element. And there we go, the product HC1500 has been specified. Next up would be the serial number. And for that, let's just drill down into this. There's our serial number. And for the photo, in this case, I can use any JPEG or a file that I'm interested in, any picture file that I'm interested in or that I have available. I'm just going to upload something that I know is going to be on just about everybody's computer who's working with this, who may be doing this at home and not on the labs. I'll go into PyPC under PySDK. And under PySDK, I'll choose, it's just a simple logo. And that is now the file that's associated, the photograph that's associated with that. But as you could see, we could have done any of those, or any JPEG file for that.